it's when it catches at the end, yeah. That was nice, dude.
So Nate had to make a run to the hardware store while I was milling this red oak. This 8 foot section, 8 and change. So he's not here to get this on video, but I just wanted to stop a second, take a look at this, show you guys, because this thing is absolutely gorgeous. See if I can get some water on it. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, this thing is beautiful. Great grain. See, looks really, really good. You get it wet, then you come down here to this end. This end of the log was a little goofy. You can see we got some knots and stuff in it. But the saw pulled, the mill pulled through it okay, made it a couple nice flat cuts. So gonna keep going. This is gonna be 4.5 by 6 for some supports we need over there on the mill shed. Just wanted to stop and show off how beautiful this log was. Over here last night shooting the breeze for a couple minutes. I said, you know, I still can't believe we used that black walnut on the trusses. And he goes, well, think about it this way. Didn't cost him any more than any of the rest of that wood did.
Guess you got except they hauled it from Sharpsville. I've been swinging this 4 pound hammer to get those 5/8 all thread through those beams and through the timber. You know, this thing's feeling about like Mjolnir. I kind of feel like Thor with this thing. Oak there. So we bolted through the oak, 2 pieces of plate, bolted through the schedule 40, bolted up through the timber, through the oak again, and have a plate on top or a piece of angle on top squeezing down on the bolts. One feels good. I may at some point run some legs up in. But it took a lot of the sway out of the building. So we got drip edge on. It's So Austin's got the drip edge on. We need to put the vapor barrier down and then start putting the metal up. But we had to get some cross bracing. So this oak tree was in my parents' backyard. They had it taken down, and Austin and I, this is our first one, and we finally got it. All the holes to line up, it was a lot of work, but it sure has made a difference for stability. Jonathan and I are gonna try to get one up on this corner. Well, Austin might help me tomorrow, and if we get that one done, Jonathan and I can start putting sheet metal up on Saturday. That's the plan anyways. So it's time to go home. This feels like about day 20 for the sawmill shed build. You know, I can't help myself. I start something and I don't go halfway on anything. It's just full, like, this isn't a sawmill shed. This is a sawmill mahal. So it's a little bit overkill. That's my MO. I overdo it. So, can't help myself. It's just, I've always been that way. But hey, thanks for watching. If it's your first time on the channel, thanks for stopping by. We're a maple syrup company, but we have a wood yard. And now we have a flatbed dump truck that we'll use to pick up logs and take lumber to the kiln, pick up lumber. And during the maple season, we'll use it to haul sap. Sap Squatch is gone. I sold it to Bill Gurich from Cold Springs Cartage. They haul our sap anyways, and just didn't make sense having that thing around and just being used once or twice a month. So Bill's gonna be using it for hauling milk about this time of year during the fair season. And we have a new Sap Squatch. It's a little bit more, I don't know, versatile. But thanks for checking in with us, and we'll catch you in the next episode. You ready to go home, Charlie? Come on. Good boy.